plate. Here's Jason Hayward. Nice round of applause for him. He bounces into a potential double play. Simmons the flip, then the bare hand and a stretch. Wow, what a double play. That could be the one tonight on Fox Sports Live.
When we talked about Simmons, his great defense that came in and made that the tough play look very easy. He had the toughest part come in on this. It wasn't a hard hit. Flipped the ball back to his second baseman. Jace Peterson came over from San Diego in the B.J. Upton trade. And, you know, he makes a nice play defensively. He's trying to make the team probably is more like a utility player, the second baseman, Jace Peterson.
They have a young second baseman in the minor leagues by the name of Jose Peraza that they love.
He's a very speedy player, high batting average, but he's only played like A and double A. He's the second base of the future. Converted shortstop, but because of Simmons, they got to move him to second, and they can't wait for him to get here.
Here's an 0-1 pitch to Matt Holliday. Up the middle, Peterson, backhands from his knees. Have an inning, young man. How about those plays defensively? Jace Peterson. The turn on the double play and a backhanded stop of this shot off the bat of Matt Holliday. That's how you make a team. Nicely done.
It's only
the fly ball out to shallow right and running in to make the catch, Turdoslovich.
John Jay is the only one that proved last year that he could hit left-handers, but is that a fluke or is that going to be the norm?
This afternoon, Fox Sports Midwest televising the Missouri High School Basketball Championships presented by Bomarito Automotive Group. Catch the boys and girls class 4 and 5 finals live today on FoxSportsMidwest.com and Fox Sports Midwest Plus. Check FoxSportsMidwest.com for the schedule. One out, nobody on. Here's Yadier Molina. Your first look at a slimmed down catcher of the Cardinals.
Well, I got a chance to see him in January with the fantasy camp, but he looks like he's even lighter than he was in those days. The question is, you know, has he lost too much weight? Now, you can understand he lost the weight for very valid and good reasons. You know, one, he wants to take pressure off those knees. He's getting older. It'd be a lot more beneficial to him. But I will say this, Dan. It may be surprising to you, but it's a little easier to put weight back on than it is to take it off. So,
been there, done that.
Yeah, if he feels like, you know, he needs to gain a little more weight for the stress of the season, that'll be easy to accomplish.
Here's a 2-1 pitch to Yadier Molina. And he hits a fly ball out to deep right field. Turdoslovich back in, makes the catch. How about the defense being shown by the Braves so far in this game? Outstanding.
Well, that's one thing they can do. They can play a pretty good defense. I remember when Hayward was out there in right field, he was going to do it. You mentioned earlier, Turdoslovich is playing right, but that's going to be Markakis' job. And, you know, he signed a 4-year, $44 million contract. He's coming off a neck surgery. They do expect him, or at least before spring training, expect him to be ready for the regular season, but he hasn't played yet.
Here's Peralta. Started to swing the bat much better 4 or 5 games ago. Average now this spring at 250, one home run and one RBI. 21 home runs a year ago, all-time record for Cardinals shortstops in a single year.
I think he was the best offensive shortstop in the National League last year, and I think we were all pleasantly surprised with how he performed defensively.
We don't question it now,
nope,
do we?
Not at all.
Here's a 2-0. Two balls and one strike. He was the first Cardinals shortstop to lead the team in home runs since all the way back in 1899. Bobby Wallace was the shortstop then and led the club in homers.
Saw him, but I never played with him.
Fangraphs had a real nice write-up on Bobby Wallace, and his numbers did, I think, compute into today's day and age. with sabermetrics. The 2-2. Again, Turdoslovich near the Cardinal bullpen in foul territory, and he makes the catch. Beautiful afternoon. It's like Groundhog Day here. It's 2 seconds remaining on that clock, which here at the ballpark is situated below the main scoreboard at Roger Dean as Long grounds out to first. The batter must be in the box from 20 to 5 seconds left. So they're trying to shave off any kind of extra time that they can and speed up the game if they can.
Well, it's interesting, Dan. You know, somewhere I was accused of probably the only guy that really knew about the 20-second clock. You know, with no batter or no runners on base, you have 20 seconds to deliver a pitch. The average of major league guys now is about 24 seconds in between. But there was no time limit with men on base, and that's when guys take more time. But 20 seconds is a long time. I did all my stuff and still got back inside 20 seconds.
Here's Peter Borges hitting 080. It's been a tough spring. Now, he did homer the last game here, as Peter told us after the game that his wife, who's 8.5 months pregnant, told him, you need to just start relaxing. So what we're going to do, and he was looking at his stance and holding his hands differently in the mirror, we're going to the beach, and you're not going to talk about baseball. There's no mirrors. You can't look at your stance, and the next day he hits a home run. So I guess the lesson learned is, Al, if we have a bad game, let's go to the beach. You in or out?
I'm in.
I'm in, too. That's what he needs to do, is go the other way. We'd like to see him spray the ball a little bit. Line drives. Home runs are nice, but with his speed, if he could spray the ball, he could be a dangerous at bat.
Well, you know, he's a slow learner. Now, I said, Peter, you got married in the offseason. Yeah. He was engaged. He started dating his wife 11 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
11 years ago. She didn't give him an ultimatum until last year. He said, I'm getting it all out of the way. The wedding and now the...
little check swing and
they have
foul
a baby
ball.
Due on April 21st, he told me. It's a due date.
Hey, hello to Annette Weinstor at Nazareth Living Center and Father Edwin Albers. Dan and family are down here enjoying the sunshine. Hopefully Annette is enjoying Cardinals baseball on Fox Sports Midwest today.
I thought Dan was such a good son, he'd bring his mom down here with him.
Well, we'll have to ask him. The 0-2, that's swung on and missed. Buck will throw to first, and a strikeout of Peter Borges on the breaking ball. You know, the managers many times will get together in these spring training games and say, what do you want to do? You got a guy that needs extra ABs, we can DH. Do you want your pitcher to hit? And with dealing with an abdominal strain, I'm not sure swinging a bat would be the best thing for him, but regardless, he pops it into shallow right, and the catch is made.
And then Martinez probably is slated to go at least 4 innings himself.
Matt Carpenter singled to center, first time up, back in the first. Chin Ming Wong is the starter today for the Atlanta Braves. He's given up just one hit. And the 0-1. Shortstop, Andrelton Simmons puts it away for the first out. He's fun to watch, boy, with that glove. I know that's routine, but he makes some of these plays that are not routine look routine.
Outstanding find out of Curacao, where the Braves have had some pretty good ones come out of that tiny Caribbean country. And there, Carlos, who is still vying for that fifth spot, but because of what Garcia has done, he's kind of put himself right in the pitcher. And
so is Marco Gonzalez.
Marco Gonzalez.
It's good to have competition.
Oh, brings out the best in you. And I'm sure we're going to talk an awful lot about Carlos.
1-0 pitch to Hayward. Atlanta native. One point, the number one overall prospect in all of baseball. First plate appearance ever in the big leagues. A home run. He grounds it right side and a base hit.
Jason, who a couple years ago had as many as 27 home runs, last year in the leadoff spot. And everybody's a little bit concerned that all of his base hits this spring have all been singles. They'd like to have him do some damage in that two hole and kind of get himself back to really being a dangerous hitter. Altered his thinking a little bit in the trying to get the high on base percentage as a leadoff hitter, but I think the Cardinals would like him to attack the ball and get some long ball threat.
Now it's Holiday with Hayward, the runner at first, as he was just standing next to his best friend, and that's Freddie Freeman. Those two are having a laugh. Now Hayward is a threat to steal. Double play ball, 6-4-3, double play. That's what Chin Ming Wong can do, ground ball after ground ball when he's right. And already the Braves have turned two double plays. We head to the fifth, and there's no score.
Last year,
spring training, and that pitch is hit high in the air, out to left. Phil Gosselin shielding from the sun over to make the catch, and Adams back to the bag at first.
About how the lineup almost gave in play.
You were asking me earlier who's been impressive in spring, and the first name I mentioned was Pete Cosma. I also think Reynolds has taken some really good at-bats and looked good this spring, too. As Peralta swings in.
Play first.
And in your pick, I thought with the, it's a cut. I think
behind that plate more and more, and you know, he doesn't like it when he's out of the lineup, but at times, you know, it puts stress on his knees. That should help out that area too.
3-2 is taken for a ball, and the runners have advanced. Adams to second, Peralta at first. Activity, a right-hander getting loose in the pen for the Atlanta Braves, and the hitter will be Colton Wong. It's the first walk issued by Chin Ming Wong.
Remember, Wong's making his first strike, Wong and Wong. Making Chin Ming Wong making his first start, so he may be running out of gas. And Colton is loving this, not looking over my shoulder. Mm-hmm. I'm the second baseman, spring training.
His hit is 174. And he grounded out to first, his first time up, looks at a strike. Peter Borges is on deck.
Colton had the great power numbers the second half, then three home runs in postseason.
Including
that. I want to think him about a line drive.
And a ground ball that's hit to first. Freeman will take it. Steps on the bag. Runners advance to second and third.
Perfect time for Peter Borges to add a little more confidence. Come through in the clutch.
Well, with double switches, and you think about how good the Cardinals could be defensively in the outfield late innings, Peter Borges is an important part of that discussion. You know, he came over as a highly thought of defensive player. Never really got on track last year.